Hello students, today we are going to start chapter number 6, operations on set. In your previous classes you have learned about the definition of sets, representation of sets, different type of sets, cardinal number of sets and universal, equivalent and subsets. If you have any doubt related to these basic terms, then you can go through the link given in the description box. In this chapter, we will discuss about the operations on sets. First operation is union of two sets. So union of two sets means the set which contain the element of A and B both. So, and how we will denote it? A, U, B. U means union of two sets. And how we will write? A union B means X such that X belongs to A or X belongs to B. Now you can understand with the help of an example. Suppose if you have two sets, one set A is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 and then another set is 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So A union B will be the combination of these two sets. We have to add these two sets. So first write the first set. And then write the second set. As you can see, 4 and 5 already I have written. So we will not repeat 4 and 5. Once it is enough. Now 6, 7 and 8 is the answer. So A union B is the addition of all the elements of A and B. But we will not repeat if any element is repeating. You can see 4 and 5, 4 and 5. We will write it once only. Next operation we have intersection of sets. So intersection of two sets means the set which consists the common elements from the given sets. And how we will denote it? A intersection. This U direction you have to flip in the opposite direction. So A intersection B. And A intersection B means X such that X belongs to A and X belongs to B. It means the element should belongs to both the set. For example, if we have a set A, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, last example only we have taken, and B is another set, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So A intersection B means the element which belongs to both the set. So you can see here this 4 is there in both the sets. So 4 will come here and 5 is also in both the sets. So 5 also will come. So 1, 2, 3 only is in A. 6, 7, 8 only in B. So A intersection B means only the common elements we have to write once. Third operation we have difference of two sets. It is denoted by A minus B and A minus B means X such that X belongs to A and X does not belongs to B. It means the element should belongs to the first set but should not belongs to the second set. For example, if we have A 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 and B another set is 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then A difference B means first you have to write the element of first set. Always write the element for the first set first. And from that difference B means which all elements are in B that we have to remove. So start 4 is there in B, 5 is also there in B. So 4 and 5 we have to remove. So A difference B means 1, 2 and 3. Only these 3 elements will come. And if we have to find out B difference A, so then we will write the B first. B is 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and then we will scratch out the elements which are in A. So 4 is there in A and 5 is there in A. So answer is here 6, 7 and 8. Next operation on sets, we have complement of a set. It is denoted by A dash or A to the power C or A bar. So normally in book it is denoted by A dash only. So complement of set, any set means from universal set, just subtract this set, difference of this set from the universal set. Or we can say A complement is x such that x belongs to universal set and x does not belongs to A. So if suppose universal set is given 1 to 10 and A set is given 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, then A complement means from universal set you have to subtract A. So write first universal set. And scratch out the elements of A. So 1 to 5 are in A. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 we don't want. So answer is here 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So complement of set is nothing else. It is difference of set only. Difference of any set with the universal set. Next we will discuss about the overlapping sets. Two sets we will say overlapping if they have at least one element in common, or in other words we can say if A intersection B is not equal to empty set. If something is common between two sets, then we will call them overlapping set. And disjoint set is the opposite of overlapping set. If two sets have nothing common, there is no element common in between two sets, then we will call them disjoint sets. And how we can write? We can write A intersection B is equal to empty set. If nothing is common between two sets, then they are disjoint sets. Now we will start exercise 6, question number 1. If A is 0, 1, 2, 3 up to 8, B is 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, C is 0, 5, 10, 20. Find A union B, A union C, B union C, A intersection B, A intersection C and B intersection C. And we have to write cardinal number also. Cardinal number means the number of elements in the set. So first A union B means we will write the elements of A and B together without any repetition. So first write A, 1, 2, 0 also is there, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. After that now start from the B, 3. Already we have written 3, so we will not repeat it. 5 also we have written, 7 also we have written and now 9, 9 and 11. And cardinal number of this set, we will write like this, N, A union B. N means the cardinal number of this set. Now you can count how many elements are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So cardinal number of this set is 11. Second we have A union C. So first write the elements of A. After that now see the elements of C. 0 already we have written, 5 also we have written, now remaining is 10 and 20. Cardinal number of A union C, again count the number of elements, here also you will get the same 11 elements. Third part we have B union C, so first write B and now come to the C. 0 we have not written, so we will write. 5 already we have written, so we will skip 5, 10 and 20. And cardinal number of this set is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it is having 8 elements. Next we have A intersection B. So what is common in A and B? So in A we have 1, 2, 8 and B we have 3, 5, 7, 9, 11. So if you see carefully, 3 is there in A also, 5 is also there in A and 7 also is there in A. So only 3, 5 and 7, these three elements are there in both A and B. So 3, 5, 7 is answer here. Cardinal number of A intersection B is 3. Next, A intersection C. So we have to check which all numbers are common in A and C. So 0 is common and 5 is common. Cardinal number of A intersection B C is 2, because 2 elements we have. Third part, we have B intersection C. So in B and C, what is common? In B we have 3, 5, 7, 9, 11. In C we have 0, 5, 10, 20. So only 5 is common in B and C. So here we will get 5. Only one element is there. So cardinal number of B intersection C is 1. Next we have question number 2. Find A complement when A is given 0, 1, 4, 7 and universal set is given X such that X belongs to whole number and X is less than 10. So first, this universal set we will change into the roster form. X is here a whole number and less than equal to 10. And we know whole number starts from 0 and we will go up to 10, because this limit is given equal to 10. Now we have to find out the A complement. A complement means universal set minus A. So first write the universal set. And then scratch out the elements of A. So 0, 4, 7, 1 also. So remaining elements 2, 3, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10. Are the elements of A complement. Second part, we have A is consonant and universal set is the alphabet of English alphabets of English. Then we have to find out the A complement. A complement means from universal set we have to remove A. And as we know, in English alphabet we have total 26 letters. From these 26 letters, 5 are the vowels and remaining 21 are the consonant. So if from the 26 we will remove this 21, then what will be the remaining? Only the vowels will be the remaining. So we can write here directly A complement, we will get here vowels. Third part, we have A is given boys in the 8th standard of all schools in Bangalore. And universal set is the students in class 8th of all schools in the Bangalore. So total student means it is the addition of boys and girls together. The number of boys and the number of girls together are the total students in class 8th. So from total, if we remove boys, then remaining will be the girls. So A complement is here. From universal set we have to remove A. So from total strength, if we remove the number of boys, then we will get the girls in 8th of all schools in Bangalore. Fourth part, A is the letters in Kalka and universal set is letter in Kolkata. So first we will write in the roster form. K, A, L, only three letters will come. We will not repeat. K and A is repeating again, so no need to write it again. And universal set we have K, O, L, A and T. And A complement means from the universal set we have to remove A. So first write the universal set. And then remove the A. A, we have K, A and L. So answer is here O and T. Fifth part, we have A is the odd natural numbers and universal set is whole numbers. So A complement means from the universal set we have to remove A. from whole numbers we have to remove all the odd numbers. So what we will get? We will get 0, 2, 4, 6 and so on. And 0, 2, 4, 6, these are the set of even whole numbers. We will use here whole number because 0 is also there. If we will start only from 2, then we will write even natural numbers. So, but we have 0 also. That's why we have written even whole numbers. So, in this video, we will do till here. Remaining questions, we will continue in the next video. Thank you for watching this video.